Do you remember this time last year, back before the daily dumpster fire that is the political news cycle? I mean, it feels like a lifetime ago. And I remember feeling just completely broadsided, left reeling over the fact the United States had elected a malignant orange mole. And I mean, it got me thinking about a particular book I read over the holidays. I mean, this is book tube after all. And I was thinking about why this book was especially important to me. And this sent me down this rabbit hole of introspection, specifically about online bubbles. And I know it's been a while, but indulge me here, or don't. I'm not the boss of you. I've been living in a self-curated, algorithmically programmed social media bubble, and chances are pretty good that you are too. So let's think about this for a little bit. Every social media platform that you consume on a daily basis, it's easy to think of those as simply dumb pipes that are funneling information your way. When you stop and think about it, every piece of media you consume has been algorithmically mediated specifically for you. Your engagement is being monetized. You're not so much the customer as the product, and what's being brokered is your attention. Take Instagram, for example. If I happen to like an especially tasty looking bowl of ramen, Instagram decides I'm into ramen and starts feeding me more images of ramen. It's just trying to be helpful. Or if you want to take a more mercenary tone, it's highly invested in its own stickiness and improving that. It wants to give me what I like. It wants that dopamine hit that you get from fresh knowledge or novelty. It's the thing that gets you scrolling through your Facebook and your Twitter feeds looking for something new. It's this exploit in a vulnerability in human psychology that all social media platforms rely on. Now, if I was just given images of ramen, I'd be pretty frustrated, but it turns out I like other things like books, board games, and booze. So now Instagram has this library of, let's say, 20 different things that it can feed me, and my suggestions feel pretty diverse, despite the fact that they are very narrow. How am I supposed to know that I need menswear dog in my life if Instagram keeps feeding me images of ramen and booze? I get it. Our brains aren't equipped to handle that absolute deluge of information that's available to us online. And so we let platforms curate that information for us while we remove all the burrs and irritations that don't spark joy or novelty. It's a way of mediating all the information that's available to us, and we're happily living within these curated little bubbles, and I don't usually think too much about it. Take a look at your Twitter feed. If you're like me, it's probably remarkably homogenous. I mean, Twitter is this singular engine that is fueled by bullshit, snark, and outrage. My Twitter feed is mostly liberal-leaning, Trump is an asshat, Oprah for president, why that's good or bad, with minor deviations into the latest meme, but otherwise maintains quite a consistent tone. I've worked to curate that. I've removed voices that irk or oppose. And so I've created this bubble that serves up bite-sized bits of novelty that reinforce my worldview and make me feel good. And it promotes this vague sense of groupthink that undeniably comes from a place of privilege. And YouTube, do you know how hard it is to find new content? I mean, trending is an absolute dumpster fire that makes me feel old and out of touch. And I'm pretty sure there's more to YouTube than just BookTube, but you'd never know it by looking at my recommended. True novelty has been completely programmed out of my feeds. Now, maybe I just don't get social media. I'm old enough that it's not a stretch to feel that my frustration is born out of my irrelevance, that I just simply don't get it. I'm the old man shaking his fist at all the kids running around his online yard, talking about the good old days of chat rooms and BBSs. And hell, I'm just talking about the narrow curation of interest. There's a larger conversation that could be had, that Facebook has increased partisanship, that has allowed Russians to influence our elections, that Instagram is responsible for a spike in teen depression and suicide, that Twitter gives voice to neo-Nazis, that YouTube has different rules for their cash cows. So I've been trying to be more aware of how my choices are being influenced and how to get outside of my own little bubble. How do you guys get out of your bubble? Who or what informs your media consumption? It's also part of the reason why I stepped away from BookTube for a little while. I decided I would just read whatever the heck I wanted. I read a lot of genre fiction, a lot of sci-fi, horror, detective thrillers, just whatever the hell I felt like, without in the back of my mind thinking about how I was going to talk about it on BookTube. And this was at the tail end of the larger discussion that was happening all throughout BookTube about reader fatigue, falling out of love of reading, and the tyranny of Goodreads. And I apologize for bringing it all back up now that it's been settled long ago, but that also influenced my step away. I thought, what is it like to read back when I used to read without BookTube? And turns out it was a lot of fun. The irony, of course, is that I'm going to come back to BookTube and talk about it here on BookTube. But anyway, that's just the way it is. Happy New Year. It's good to be back, and we will talk to you soon. Bye.